Hi guys, I'm here today making a video about the process of how I work, or at least one of the processes of how I work. So, today I'm working on an illustration for the line it is drawn, comic book resources, doing a homage cover of Kingdom Come, and we're doing Firestorm, the Nuclear Man. So, I was just showing you some of the reference I have for this. I already did the typography to start this off, because I'm sure that would eat up some time in the video, and you know that long videos people don't really sit through, so anyways, typography's already done. I can get into that another day someday, who knows. So this is what I'm gonna do. Basically, here we are. We're just going to start, and what I'm doing is I'm working in a grayscale format, and what I like to do, and this is just one technique that I use sometimes, is that I start with like the darker colors and I paint things in roughly. Now, I just showed my brushes really quickly on what I'm using, and what I'm using is just a hard mechanical brush, so that means there's like no feathers to the edges, and it's said to have like a wet appearance. Basically, it's also, I'm using a stylus, so therefore, like, a white Wacom tablet, and I just paint with this, and I vary the opacity, usually between around 40 to 70% of my brush, so that when I'm sketching things out. And right now, I'm just kind of blocking in the masses for the, you know, the effects in the background that you've seen on Alex's Ross's piece that I'm doing homage of. So this is really loose and rough, and, you know, it doesn't have to be exactly perfect, you know. Once I've done putting in those colors, or shades, I will say, I use what's the smudge tool. And if you looked, I also show the settings that I use for that. And I use something that's really gritty, almost like a steel wool brush. And this way it kind of spatters the pixels a bit and blends as it does it. And I also vary the strength of this as well, you know, anywhere from like 40 to 70, sometimes even 90%. And once I've got that, then I'm just going to throw in a color layer over top. I just set that layer to color and filled it with red because that's basically it. And so now I can just kind of refine things as I just push the pixels around and smudge them to try and get that same effect that we had on this cover. And now I'm moving on to another step. So what I'm doing now is I'm adding in an extra element. I'm creating one of those like nuclear atom symbols that we see so much with Firestorm. So the way I'm doing this is I'm using the pen tool and I'm having it stroke my brush. So this way I'm kind of getting those curves and arcs. Then I'll just brush in where I want more solid things. So I created a new layer over top with a clipping mask, so this way that anything I'm painting now doesn't go outside that original darker gray. And I'm just painting from darker colors to lighter ones, and I just keep, you know, lightening up what color I'm selecting. Once I've done that, again, I'm just using the smudge tool, and I smudged it. Of course, now again, I also created a color layer. And I just kind of placed it over top and then fit it in. So after I was done all that, I kind of flattened it in the sense so that it's not a clipping mask, and using my smudge tool, I'm just trying to refine this so that I kind of get these, you know, explosions and such going on across it as it travels through this atom, per se. So, yeah, a little bit of dodge and burn, dodge actually, to brighten that up. So, now I'm moving on to actually him himself, and created a new layer, and I'm just kind of blocking in the silhouette of the shape, you know, kind of to mimic the pose Superman was in, but not exactly. So working with this black, you know, kind of I just get a silhouette of how I want him to look. And once I'm happy, what I'm doing is just duplicating that layer a whole bunch of times and then merging it, so I don't have to keep wasting time filling him in. So, and essentially, again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to work from dark to light. So I grab the next kind of shade that I want. It's a basic color. And I'm just going to paint in where I want more of the highlights. And I'm just going to keep lightening that up and bringing out more and more highlights, because, you know, I want this to be kind of, like, dark, but, you know, lighter in the top part. The thing is that once I've done that, I have some basics, and that just kind of smudges in. And this is really just to get a rough color palette going, or a tonal range, you know, and you can really see that. Then I start to refine things. So, like, right now, I'm just moving on the nose, and I'm just taking colors of gray, or shades of gray, and slowly moving things in, going back from my brush to the smudge tool and smudging things in as I go. So, I like using the smudge tool because, like, something like the mixer brush in Photoshop, I found that it eats up a lot of RAM and chud, so I kind of just stick with this old technique that I actually learned from watching a video called Hostile Takeover, and you can check it out. It's by Brad Rigney. He goes also by the name Crip Crawler on, like, DeviantArt and such. So, and of course, this video is extremely sped up. I mean, the entire process took, I'd say, about 5 hours from start to finish, but nobody wants to sit through 5 hours of someone painting, you know. Watching paint dry is not exactly the best thing in the world to do or waste your afternoon on. So, and again, so just basically, like, just pulling the pixels with the smudge tool, and then really just layering in shades of gray right now. So, like, off to the other side of my screen that I'm not recording, I have, like a gradient of black to white, so that I can just select different colors or shades again, and this way I can just pick something that's more close to what I want. So I'm just kind of refining him, making sure that, you know, he looks like how I want. It works pretty good. I like this technique. I mean, I can spend a lot more time on it to get some, like, hyper-realism, but I kind of still want more sketchy brushstroke kind of look, you know, rather than something that's absolutely perfect. You know, because, I mean, if you really want something perfect, you can spend the time for that hyper-realism, but sometimes I just think, if you're going to waste that much time, then you might as well just take a photo. Right now, I'm just kind of making a selection with the pen tool, and I just want to clean up these bands and stripes that go around it. So, this way I can throw a cleaner edge. So I end up painting one of these jewel kind of things on, but instead of painting it multiple times, I just recreated it, pasted it, altered them slightly, saved a little bit of time. Here I'm using what's called the puppet wrap tool, upper warp, I believe. And you can add pins and anchor points, because I just wanted to fix that arm. It just wasn't feeling right. And basically, it almost works like hinge joints. You should just look it up if you're interested, or just ask me about it. I can tell you more about how to use that tool. And it's pretty neat. I love it. Kind of just jumped in here to the color phase. Again, I just created a new layer, set it to a clipping mask, set it to color mode, and you just apply the color. It just goes over those gray tones. And basically, it colors it. Sometimes I have to make some adjustments to some colors, so, but like I'm doing here with the yellow. And then overall, I just kind of played with some things like some photo filters just to get the tone right. I increased the size of the nuclear kind of explosion behind him. And then I created a gray layer and set it to overlay, and basically used Dodge and Burn to bring out some more highlights. And I do that instead of working right on the drawing with Dodge and Burn, because Dodge and Burn is, like, destructive. And if you create a gray layer, it's non-destructive, and therefore you can just fix it up. Just a couple other little things I've done here, but, you know, overall we're just about finished. But, I mean, hey, if you have any questions, you can always simply just contact me, write me, you know, and it's fine. I don't mind answering questions sometimes, if time permits, of course. So, yeah, we're just about done. Added a little bit of noise to give it more of a textured feel, almost like the watercolor paper that he uses, I'm sure. Just some levels, and yeah. Pretty good. Oh, that nose. Way too big, I found. Kind of fixed it up. I still think it's kind of big, but hey, whatever. He's got character now. Firestorm with the big nose. Anyways. Thanks again for watching. Here it is, the final. Take care.